Hello friends, welcome to our channel. In this video I will explain another example on double integration whose limits are not provided directly. So see this problem. Evaluate double integral of the function x plus y with respect to x and with respect to y, where r is the region bounded by the ellipse. Okay, you are all very familiar to the equation of the ellipse, whose equation is x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. In the standard form of the ellipse, always a is greater than b. Okay, this is the standard equation of the ellipse, which is in first quadrant. Don't worry. Okay, so everybody knows that the shape of the ellipse is this one, and since a is greater than b along x axis, a dash a is the major axis whose coordinates are minus a comma 0, because a dash lies on negative x axis, and coordinates of a, which is on positive x axis, is a comma 0. And in the similar way, this is b, 0 comma b, and this is 0 comma minus b. Okay, this is the rough graph of the ellipse. Okay, we are observing that our region R does not lies entire the ellipse. Okay, our region is lies in just first quadrant by this ellipse. So this is only our region. Okay, so please read the problem carefully. Here our region is not in the entire ellipse, just bounded by first quadrant by this ellipse. This is the arc of the ellipse, x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. Okay, write the solution. We know that the ellipse x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. Take it equation number 1. Intersects x axis at a comma 0 and minus a comma 0 as shown in figure. And equation number 1 intersects y axis at b comma 0 and minus b comma 0. Okay, just give the brief explanation about ellipse. This is the brief explanation of ellipse. Okay, and one more important thing is, here order of the integration is provided as dx dy. Okay, this problem is different to the previous discussed problems in the previous videos. Okay, in previous problems, order of the integration is provided as dy dx. Don't forget it. But here, order of the integration is provided as dx dy. Okay, so from figure, given double integral becomes x plus y of dx dy over r. In this case, first we should express y limits as constants. Y limits should be expressed as constant. After that, we should express x limits as in terms of y. Okay, this problem is different to the previous problems. In earlier problems, always we should fix the x limits as constant and y limits in terms of x. Okay, but this problem is different because order of the integration is provided as dx dy instead of dy dx. That's why in this type of problems, first we should express y limits as constants. Okay, this is origin, everybody knows that. So in this region, this is our region, observe the y coordinates. So here 0, here 0, here b. That's why y varies from minimum to maximum value. So y varies from 0 to b. Now we should express x limits in terms of y. So for y limits, sorry, for x limits, take a horizontal strip. In earlier problems, we took the vertical strip to find y limits in terms of x. But we need here x limits in terms of y. Okay, that's why take a horizontal strip for x limits. Okay, these x limits gives the y limits in terms of y. Okay, this is the horizontal strip. Horizontal strip. Okay, don't forget to draw this figure, because limits of the integrations are not provided directly here. Instead of the limits, a region is provided in this problem. So whenever region is provided instead of the limits of the double integrals, you should draw the figure. It is mandatory for every problem. Okay? So we are observing that y varies from 0 to b by using the vertices of the region, and x varies from, this is the lower part of the horizontal strip, which is y-axis whose equation is 0. So lower limit is 0. What about upper limit? Okay, from the upper limit, you should find out the value of x. Okay, equation of the ellipsis x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. From this, x square by a square is equal to 1 minus y square by b square. From this, x square is equal to a square into, take the LCM, you will get b square in the denominator, b square minus y square. By taking the LCM, you will get x is equal to a by b into root over b square minus y square. You should take the equation of this arc as this one. So this is the upper limit. X varies from 0 to a by b root over b square minus y square of the function. So x plus y dx dy. In this way, we can find out the limits of x and y. Okay. So if the order of the integration is dx into dy, inner integral should be x limits, because first we are going to find out the integration with respect to x. After that, we should take the integration with respect to y. Okay, this is very, very important point. Okay. Now write the integration with respect to x. Integral y is equal to 0 to b. Whenever we are taking the integration with respect to x, y is constant, but first term is x, whose integration is x square by 2, and integration of y with respect to dx is xy, y is a constant. Okay. Integration is completed with respect to x, that's why you should apply the limits. Y is equal to, sorry, x is equal to 0 to b, root over b square minus y square into dy. Okay. It is enough to simplify that integration. That's enough. For this type of problems, very important thing is, by drawing the region of the given curves, which is bounded by given curves, and obtain the limits of that region, which is very, very important. Okay. So that is equal to integral y is equal to 0 to b. Apply the upper limit. You will get x square, a square by b square. A square by b square. Already in the denominator we have 2. So 2b square and root over b square minus y square whole square. Root getting cancelled. So b square minus y square plus y into, what is x? Upper limit. A by b root over b square minus y square whole into dy. By applying law limit, x every term becomes 0. That's why. So now split the terms. A square by 2b square is the constant term. Integral y is equal to 0 to b. Remaining part is b square minus y square of dy plus a by b is the constant term. Integral y is equal to 0 to b. Remaining term is y into root over b square minus y square into dy. Now take the integration of the first part. A square by 2b square of integration of b square with respect to y is constant. That's why its integration is b square y minus integration of y square with respect to y is y cube by 3. Integration is completed in the first part. We should apply the limits now. Now, please see the second part. In the second part, please observe the derivative of the inner term. B square, derivative of b square is 0 and derivative of y square is minus 2y. That's why you should multiply with the 2 minus 2 and divide with the minus 2. That's why you will get a by minus 2b into integral y is equal to 0 to b minus 2y into this can be written as b square minus y square whole power 1 by 2 of d1. Okay? That is equal to a square by 2b square. Apply the upper limit whenever we have y. So b square into b, b cube minus replace y by upper limit. You will get b cube by 3 minus 0 by applying lower limit 0 minus. We are observing that this is in the form of f dash of x into f of x whole power n. What is n value? 1 by 2. So the result of this formula is f of x whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1. That's why you will get b square minus y square whole power 3 by 2 by 3 by 2. Within the limits, integration is completed. That's why substitution the limits is mandated. Okay, now a square by 2b square into, by taking the LCM here, 3b cube minus b cube, 2b cube by 3 minus, here 2 getting cancelled, 3 is the constant term, please write outside. So a by 3b, by applying upper limit, b square minus b square, 0 minus, by replacing y value by 0, you will get b square whole power 3 by 2. Okay, now b square cube getting cancelled, 2 getting cancelled. So in the first part, you will have only a square for b, a square b by 3. Observe the second part, minus of minus plus a by 3b, b square whole power 3 by 2, 2 getting cancelled, simply you have b cube. So a square b by 3 plus 1b getting cancelled here, b square is there, so a b square by 3. So this can be written as a b by 3. A is the common term, b is another common term, in the denominator 3 is the common term. So you have another a in the first part, you have another b in the second part. So this is the result. The final conclusion is double integral x plus y dx dy for r, where r is the region bounded by the ellipse in the first quadrant only. The result is ab by 3 of a plus b. This is the conclusion.